And welcome to ESPN's College Basketball. It's the MGM Grand Main Event, a part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's, and the championship game tonight in Las Vegas, the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa against the Oklahoma State Cowboys. So an interstate matchup here a long way from home. Starting lineups for the Golden Hurricane NCAA tournament team from last year: Smith, Harrison, Ray, James Woodard, who is a star, one of the underrated players in the country, and DeAndre Wright for Oklahoma State, Anthony Hickey Jr., the LSU transfer, Phil Forte, Jeffrey Carroll, LeBrian Nash, senior leading scorer for the Cowboys, and Michael Cobbins. Dave Fleming, Stephen Howard, happy to have you with us here from Las Vegas. And we get an interesting matchup, two teams, two programs that have played head-to-head many times over the years, both advancing to this championship game or this holiday event with wins on Monday and looking for a nice non-conference win before celebrating Thanksgiving tomorrow.
And I think both of these teams, Dave, did it defensively. They're two teams that get their offense from their defense. They do it kind of differently, but they're both very effective, really disrupting the offense of the opposition.
So the Cowboys out of the Big 12, the Hurricane out of the American, first-year team of the American, and the tip controlled by Oklahoma State. They've got the first possession of the ball game.
Pay attention to LeBrian Nash. He takes a shot on 32% of the possessions of Oklahoma State. That's top 40 in the country as far as possession is concerned.
Well, here's Nash looking to get free for a shot. Forte, long range, off iron, rebound controlled by Rashad Smith.
Phil Forte really struggled from three in that first game on Monday. Late, he hit some big ones, but he's the guy that needs to be effective from deep in order for LeBrian Nash to have some room down low to operate.
Now, DeAndre Wright, he is sort of the emerging star for Tulsa. Nice move for the first bucket of the game.
And he's a guy that has to really star for them. When he and Woodard graduated from high school, they were both 1-2 in Oklahoma as far as best players are concerned. So this is really what they expect of him with Tulsa.
There's a shot from Nash, way too strong. Cobbins going for the offensive rebound contact. And that's going to be a foul against Tulsa. Well, there is Travis Ford, Stephen, who is in his seventh year as the head coach of Oklahoma State. And it is a different team, most especially with no Marcus Smart.
It is. You're looking at the Big 12 Player of the Year. So on any team, that's going to leave a huge void. But when you have a guy that is the heart, soul, the leadership of your basketball team, and you can see Oklahoma State really struggling to find that leader on the court.
Cobbins was not expecting the pass. Hickey, chance to be a leader, even as a transfer. Carroll, the freshman, too strong on the three. Tulsa grabs the board.
It's important for Carroll to make his first couple baskets because he kind of struggles with confidence in it. If he doesn't make those shots, then he tends to disappear in games.
Woodard, that was a tough contested three. The rebound and saved. No, not saved. Oklahoma State gets it back. So James Woodard misses the shot for Frank Haith, who has been a long time and very successful college coach, but it's his first year at Tulsa.
And he seems to be a master at taking teams that are transitioning to new leagues. He did it with Miami, going from the Big East to the ACC. He did it with Missouri, going to the SEC, and now with Tulsa, going to the American Athletic Conference.
Forte, good defense there by Harrison. Hickey open, he misses the shot. Rebound, here comes Tulsa.
Both of these teams really want to push the pace, get up and down. Tulsa, they'll either want to take a shot in the first 10 seconds or milk it down to the last 10 seconds of the shot clock.
Jeffrey Carroll, freshman, with the rebound. Oklahoma State trying to push. Hickey almost lost it. Forte, nice job to prevent the turnover.
Well, you're going to see whoever is guarding Phil Forte have that shot awareness. You want to hawk him everywhere where he is on the court because he can shoot it from literally anywhere on the court.
Forte maybe has as much range as any player in college basketball, number 13. Nash draws the foul that time. Oklahoma State still looking for their first points, 0 for their first four from the field.
We'll credit Tulsa's defense. They're the same team that held Auburn to below 40, 35 points, so they're very capable as a defensive team.
Auburn in the game before this tournament scored 105 against a Division I team, not a cupcake opponent. They got 35 against Tulsa. There's the first bucket, and it is LeBrian Nash. Pressure from the Cowboys.
And you're going to see Oklahoma State using that pressure all game long. They love to force things in full court transition, full pressure, and grab.
Harrison, though, took advantage of it. Good job by Wright to avoid the offense of interference. The bucket counted 4-2 Tulsa. Nash scores again.
And that is what Steve LeBron Nash does that's so impressive. He's a player that off the bounce, 6'7", can carry the ball full court, back you down on the block, and then pull up for a nice 15-footer.
Rashad Ray picked up his dribble. It's going to be a challenge for him with the pressure defense from Anthony Hickey.
Yeah, Anthony Hickey is the guy that you do not want to pick your dribble up. You have to be aware of him at all times when you have the basketball.
That's a travel against DeAndre Wright.
Now, DeAndre Wright, throughout his history, really was more of a perimeter player, and the coaching staff for Tulsa have tried to get him to be more comfortable down on the block. That was an instance where you could tell a guy that's more comfortable facing the basket than back to the basket.
And Frank Hay thinks he's got a chance to play in the NBA. He's that talented. That's an illegal screen, and Cobbins knew it.
You just can't do that, Dave, when you're setting the screen. You got to be still. Whenever you lean in any way, and you saw his leg kind of stick that left knee out a little bit, they're going to get you for that because that's an area that officials are told to look at. You have to allow the defensive player room to move.
Foul against Cobbins. That goes as a turnover. Tulsa gets the ball back. Tie game 4-4. Just a few minutes in. Championship of this MGM Grand main event. Rashad Ray. Down low there is Wright, as Stephen was just saying. Closer to the basket. Trying an up and under move. Switch to the left hand. Missed the shot out of bounds off of Oklahoma State.
You see DeAndre Wright very cognizant of the fact that Michael Cobbins averages 2 blocks per game. A guy that has made his career protecting the rim for Oklahoma State.
On the inbound play. Wright will hand off to James Woodard, an impressive junior. Back to Wright. Smith, one dribble, tried to use the glass. Rebound Cowboys. Okay, just couldn't get that shot off.
Again, this is two very, very good half-court defensive basketball teams for Oklahoma State and Tulsa.
Hickey creates for Cobbins, finishing with the dunk. Smith basically one-on-one. He's going to take it. Cobbins, offensive foul. So, a good start for the Cowboys on defense, and Cobbins at the rim.
Hickey driving, dishing. Cobbins with the dunk. Oklahoma with authority up by 2. 15-21 in the first half.
Oklahoma State against Tulsa. Interstate rivalry, a long way from home in Las Vegas. The championship game of this MGM Grand main event. The Cowboys just under 5 minutes in with a 6-4 lead.
First time Oklahoma State and Tulsa have ever played outside the lovely state of Oklahoma. So this is an unprecedented event here in Vegas.
They have played many, many times in the past, although they haven't done it these last few seasons. So I think for the fan bases who love these interstate rivalries, this is kind of a treat, even if they had to move 1,500 miles away from home.
I agree.
Ryan Nash and the Cowboys with the ball. Anthony Allen, newcomer, big man in the game, and he scores right away.
And they're very high on Anthony Allen, a guy that early on in the season they were wondering what they had because he wasn't very impressive in practice, but once those bright lights came on, very productive in games, and you're going to see he and Michael Cobbins playing together, and that's going to be pretty impressive as a defensive duo on the front line.
Nash challenged the shot, but Markel Curtis off the bench hits the shot. Curtis, who comes off the bench, but they really consider him a sixth starter.
Yeah, he's a guy that can score in bunches, had 1,000 points in the junior college, so they really lean on him offensively to make things happen, kind of that spark plug off the bench.
Carroll hits Nash, he looks to face. He likes to score from that area. This time takes it closer to the basket and use the left hand.
LeBron Nash is a guy that loves contact. He loves going in the lane, getting you up with the up fake, and is very adept at playing through contact.
Dangerous pass, Woodard, good catch. Harrison challenges the shot blocker. Allen definitely altered that one.
And you're seeing the rim protection by Allen, making the offensive players of Tulsa totally alter their shot.
In transition, the freshman Jeffrey Carroll hit a three.
That's huge for Carroll. three-point line, he's shooting 36%. So having that additional three-point shooter with Phil Forte opens it up in the lane for the bigs.
Woodard with a foul. So end-to-end action and a chance for a three-point play for James Woodard.
Hell on the play by number 32, Anthony Allen. That'll be his first personal second team foul. Good field goal by James Woodard. He'll be at the line shooting one.
And we do welcome those of you joining us after the Zags get another nice early season win. Here we are in Las Vegas, championship game of this MGM Grand main event. Dave Fleming, Stephen Howard, Tulsa, Oklahoma State. And Tulsa's Shaquille Harrison hits a three.
He's a guy that hadn't been shooting well from three thus far this year, only 1 for 6, but with James Woodard, Markel Curtis, offensively, it's a team that can put up some numbers on the offensive side of the court.
State rivals meeting here in Vegas for the championship of this holiday event. LeBrian Nash off to a nice start. Tough shot, no good. Woodard high for the rebound, and here comes the Golden Hurricane. On the move, Woodard is fouled in transition. They will say it is a foul on the floor.
Good job by Woodard pushing the envelope. I thought that was a poor shot selection by LeBrian Nash. He settled for that, but good job pushing him out in the perimeter. Woodard saw advantage. He's always going to attack the rim, and that's what you want from your leading scorer, the basketball team.
So just under 7 minutes into this one, we've had some back and forth action. LeBrian Nash has 6 early points. Shaq Harrison for Tulsa has got 5. Woodard, who for 2 years running has been Tulsa's leading scorer and leading rebounder. That was sloppy. It's a turnover.
And I think early on in this game, Dave, you're seeing two good, very good defensive teams. That right there was a turnover caused by the pressure of Oklahoma State.
And part of that is what these coaches emphasize. Frank Haith, who spent 3 years at Missouri, had a lot of success there, and surprised some by taking this Tulsa head job, but very happy with the team that he has inherited.
Yeah, you're looking at a team that won the conference championship for Conference USA, a two-time leading scorer in Conference USA, still there with James Woodard. So I would say the cupboard is full for Frank Haith and Tulsa.
Foul drawn. So free throws coming up here for the Cowboys. 2-point lead for Oklahoma State out of the Big 12. 5-0 to start this year. And a nice win against Oregon State on Monday to advance to this championship. Tulsa shut down Auburn to get their semifinal win and move into this game. LeBrian Nash at the free throw line. There is the head coach of the Cowboys. 7th season for Travis Ford. No Markell Brown. No Marcus Smart. And lower expectations this year, picked toward the bottom of the Big 12 Conference, but it's a deep team, it's an athletic team, and they've got a senior, LeBrian Nash, who's got a chance to be one of the best players in the Big 12.
And being picked at the bottom of the Big 12 is not something that you should hang your head of. This is a conference that has already had 7 teams ranked in the top 25. So everyone's going to have that opportunity. The bottom of the Big 12 is as powerful as the top of a lot of other conferences.
It is a very balanced league, 10 teams only. Everybody plays the double round robin, so that's huge too.
You're seeing Oklahoma State in that full court pressure, and with Phil Forte on the, Anthony Hickey on the bench, but Phil Forte on the court, very capable duo when it comes to steals.
They made Tulsa work to get the ball up. Woodard, but the shot clock already under 20. Curtis, nowhere to go with the ball. Saved near midcourt by Dew. DeAndre Dew, the freshman, now it's Rashad Ray. Shot clock winding down. Ray heaves one up and hits it.
Dave, that was an instance of great defense and exceptional offense. Oklahoma State forced Tulsa into a late shot clock shot, and Oklahoma State not able to get the stop with Tulsa running that efficient 4-out-1-in offense.
Forte, and
that's good, good. I feel Forte.
I think they will count the basket, won't they?
They have a foul underneath.
They will, and there's a foul on Oklahoma State, but the basket will count. We'll sort through it all when we come back. Timeout in Las Vegas. Cowboys with a 4-point first half lead.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's. Lowe's, never stop improving. And Infinity. luxury cars that deliver inspired performance.
Welcome back here to Las Vegas. It's ESPN College Basketball, the MGM Grand main event, part of Feast Week, presented by Lowe's. First half action, Oklahoma State with the 17-13 lead over Tulsa. These two teams won on Monday. The Cowboys beat the Beavers of Oregon State. Tulsa over Auburn to meet here for the championship of this holiday event. Dave Fleming, Stephen Howard, happy to have you with us for some late-night hoops from Las Vegas. And, Stephen, it is sort of funny how these two in-state rivals who've played each other so many times over the years, they come all the way to Las Vegas to meet head-to-head once again.
Yeah, I think it's great for this rivalry. They've never played outside the state of Oklahoma, so I think it's great for the fans to see this. But you have two very capable teams that have got to this championship game with defense.
108th meeting all time. They first met on the basketball court back in 1907, but they have not played these last few seasons. Now they tell us they're scheduled to resume that basketball series next year, but maybe a slightly unexpected meeting here this year as they hook up with the championship belt on the line of this MGM Grand main event.
And this is big for Frank Haith and his coaching staff, that they're able to come out with a win in their first year against Oklahoma State in terms of recruiting in the state of Oklahoma. It'd be huge for them.
Yeah, huge for recruits, huge for your fans. You come up with a win against a rival. I say the same on both sides. Tulsa basketball, down by four. Rashad Ray, who has impressed us in this tournament. James Woodard at the pull-up. No good. Rebound Cowboys.
That was a tough shot by Woodard. Phil Forte, good defense. Made Woodard fall back and shoot over his contested hand.
Hickey back in the game. Hands off to Forte, who's been on the attack. Not really the strength of his game. It's out of bounds off of the Cowboys, so Tulsa gets it back.
You talk about Phil Forte, a guy that shoots the majority of his shots with a catch. He loves the no-dribble jumper. He shoots about 86% of that from his offensive repertoire. Tulsa doing a good job of pushing him out of his sweet spot and making him into a dribbler.
Against some pressure for the Cowboys, and number 12 really keys that. Anthony Hickey, the LSU transfer, was a three-year starter in the SEC, one of the better on-ball defenders in college hoops.
He really is, but you couple him with Phil Forte, who right now is fifth in the country with 4.25 steals. That's an impressive defensive duo to really lead your defensive attack.
And then Hickey on offense right through the defense for the layup.
The parting of the Red Sea, you have to stop the basketball. First thing on defense when you get back in transition.
Yeah, you might say it for both sides. Cobbins at least tried there, but Woodard will go to the free throw line.
Hickey gets the basketball and already keys it on the rim, attacks it. No rim protection, even with the defense set for Tulsa, but in that instance, no paint protection by the Tulsa Golden Hurricane.
Second foul against Michael Cobbins, so it looks like he's going to be coming out of this game. James Woodard is just 6'3", but 2 years in a row as a freshman and as a sophomore has not only led Tulsa in scoring, but in rebounding as well.
James Woodard's brother had a big game today. Oklahoma defeating UCLA, 10.0 turnovers in 31 minutes, so it's a family there of basketball players.
That's a chance to be a heck of a basketball day for the Woodards. James makes one of two, Jordan and company, moving on in that battle for Atlantis. Great tournament field there for the Bahamas. Mitchell Solomon, the freshman number 41, in for the Cowboys for the first time, with Cobbins in foul trouble. Forte dribbles into a long two and hits it.
That right there was created by LeBron Nash. Great pick on Woodard to free up Phil Forte for the easy jump shot mid-range in the short corner.
Forte's got four here in the first half. Oklahoma State's lead is seven.
And it's important that Phil Forte be aggressive offensively. You want to make Woodard work on the foul side.
Forte on defense. He missed the layup but was fouled. The whistle came a little late. Tried to spin one down. Forte took a hard fall. He'll shoot free throws.
Phil Forte, he averages 4.25 steals per game. That's top five in the country. You're seeing him with great anticipation in the passing lane, attacking and forcing Tulsa into a poor choice. But again, Phil Forte leading the defensive attack for Oklahoma State.
You use that word anticipation. I think it's a good one. He doesn't have the physical tools of Anthony Hickey or Marcus Smart, say.
Well, I asked Coach Travis Ford, how does he get all these steals? And he says that he's so strong that when there's a ball loose, he just comes up with it because guys bounce off of him.
There's that leaderboard. It's still early, but some impressive names with Phil Forte, Briante Weber, one of the great defenders in the game, Fred Van Vliet of Wichita State. Forte right there. He's not shot free throws particularly well in this tournament, which is strange considering he's typically one of the better free throw shooters around. Biggest lead of the game, 8 for the Cowboys, and the pressure bothering Tulsa again. Woodard left open, though, in and out. Right back in the game, offensive rebound. DeAndre Wright does have some range from the outside, no good.
That's where Wright feels more comfortable facing up, but LeBron Nash able to lead the break. You have four players for Oklahoma State that can push it in transition.
Nash left open, passed on the three, spins to get closer, trying to find his teammate Solomon out of bounds.
I think that was a poor choice by LeBron Nash. He was open for the three-point shot, a shot that he can make. For some reason, he was reticent to take that shot, went into traffic. Tulsa caused the turnover.
Well, one thing about LeBron Nash, he's a senior. He came in as a McDonald's All-American with huge hype. Did not live up to it, but he stuck around with Oklahoma State and has become a better player as the years have gone on.
Yeah, I mean, he's second on the team in rebounding and assists and blocks while tied for the lead in scoring. So this is a guy that's really doing what he has to do in his senior year.
That foul against Nash, his first of the night.
That'll be the sixth team foul on Oklahoma State.
Sixth team foul against Oklahoma State. Number 44, Brandon Swanigan, junior from Houston, who's mostly a defensive player, to the line.
Yeah, Newberry enters the ball game now for
Newberry, a transfer from junior college, started his career in the SEC with Ole Miss. Comes in, Phil Forte will get a rest. That one good. Swanigan makes one of two. 7-point lead for the Cowboys.
You know, I'm really surprised that LeBron Nash isn't attacking the rim more. Tulsa does not have rim protection at all. Very capable defensively, but not good rim protection, and that's where LeBron Nash lives.
Hickey upset. Somebody wasn't running the right play, so Hickey sort of resets things. Here's Nash. A couple dribbles, fade away, well short.
And that is when you're settling for a jump shot. Defensively, Tulsa is happy if LeBron Nash is taking that 15-footer from the free throw line.
There's Harrison off the screen. It's a touchdown low for Swanigan. Spins back baseline. Rebound Cowboys. Hickey on the move.
I like Tulsa trying to go at LeBron Nash and have him pick up that second very crucial foul in the first half.
How about Anthony Hickey, the runner off glass?
Against Auburn, Hickey put his imprint on the game defensively, and in the first half, Hickey is putting his imprint on the game in transition, scoring easily at the rim.
He can play.
Yeah, he can. Very impressed with him and his leadership. Coach Travis Ford wants him to be a little more vocal, but he is that leader today for Oklahoma State.
Shot, Ray rattles one down. The sophomore from New Orleans looks like he's ready to take a jump up in performance this year.
Well, the Tulsa coaching staff really worked with him on his jump shot, and you saw that with that last shot from the perimeter.
He can do a lot of other things well. If he's making shots, he's going to be a really good player. Nash, crossover, beautiful.
You're seeing DeAndre Wright really sag into the lane as if he doesn't realize that LeBron Nash can hit that jump shot.
Here's Harrison. Back to Ray. Another three. Not this time. Swanigan got his hand on the ball and grabs the offensive board. Harrison, Curtis in the corner, used that shot fake, tried to reverse, Nash was there to swat it away.
Good defensive play by Oklahoma State, and whenever you have perimeter penetration by the offense. Oklahoma State does a good job of cutting that off.
Nash never gave it up. Pulls up, hits the jumper. 10-point lead for the Cowboys.
They're not contesting any of Ryan Nash's shots on the perimeter, and he's a guy that's very capable as a perimeter jump shooter. You got to get a hand up.
Ray just couldn't quite use that screen. Now he's fouled away from the basket by Nash and Oklahoma State. So that sends us to a timeout. But, Steve, the Cowboys playing well in the first half.
Anthony Hinkie taking over in the first half. Off the glass, 10 points up. 6 minutes left.
With a 10-point lead over their in-state rivals, Tulsa, 6:11 to go until halftime. First game of the night here in Vegas featured the Auburn Tigers, who came up with a win in hoops. Probably for those folks, a slightly bigger game this weekend on the gridiron. It is the Iron Bowl, Auburn, Alabama. We've got it for you on ESPN. Saturday, 7:45 p.m. Eastern. After last year, who knows what we'll see this year in Tuscaloosa, Stephen, but it is a huge game with playoff implications for number one Alabama in particular.
Well, I don't think it has quite the importance of last year because Auburn can't get to that top four, but again, they can play spoiler to Alabama, which is always important for either of those teams.
Sure, and they definitely have a chance to go to a big time bowl game. Yeah. 15th ranked team of the country, but you're right. Last year, it was a game where both teams had national championship hopes. This year, those have probably gone away for the Tigers, but there will be a lot of emotion and a lot of memories of that classic last season in Tuscaloosa on Saturday.
Very easy for Coach Saban to get his Alabama team ready for that. I don't think he's going to have any problem getting them up for that game.
I agree with you. Rashad Ray, the junior from New Orleans. It's the first end of the 1-1. Tulsa in the bonus now. It could be that if Alabama is in the playoff, maybe their first game will be at the Sugar Bowl. That's one of the sites for a semifinal. Rashad Ray's hometown. Solomon rebounds, the free throw miss.
These last 6 minutes are very important for Tulsa because they're not a team that really has a lot of offensive firepower thus far this year. They've kind of struggled, and Oklahoma State can get on runs, particularly in transition. But Tulsa needs to get some stops and keep this within single digits.
Forte. Leighton Hammonds, who missed on Monday with an ankle problem, is in the game for the first time, a sophomore. Shot clock winding down. Hickey found an opening. Hits the three.
Hickey showing everybody that not only can he be a defensive game changer, but offensively as well.
He's got seven in this first half. Look, he's no Marcus Smart, but he can fill a lot of that void. He could be a very productive player. Jack Harrison off of Solomon out of bounds.
Taking a look at that last play in Hickey. You can just see the feel that he has. You can't allow him to dribble into a shot like that. Absolutely horrible hedge by Tulsa, a guy that's already knocked down threes and comfortable offensively. You got to push him off that line and make sure that he backs up on that dribble.
James Woodard came up with an offensive rebound that draws a foul. So Woodard back to the free throw line.
And Woodard's a guy that's very important offensively for Tulsa. Kind of came awakened last game for Tulsa. Kind of was somewhat sleepwalking offensively, but very important leading scorer for the last 2 years for Tulsa.
A guy who is going to make shots, and he wasn't making shots early in the season. Tulsa's got all the confidence in the world, but at some point they do have to start actually going in, and it looks like Woodard maybe has turned a corner.
When I talked to assistant coach Dave Lato before the game today, and he said that he saw that glimmer in his eye before they played Auburn. Got some early foul trouble, but late in the game, he was the guy that really keyed them offensively.
A very veteran coaching staff alongside Frank Haith. Really, it's kind of remarkable the staff he has assembled at Tulsa. Golden Hurricane playing defense here. Forte, short, rebound, Ray, and maybe a breakout. Although Hickey and Forte trying to get back on defense. Harrison to the corner. Repahowski knocked to the ground. Woodard sticks another one back in.
Second consecutive offensive rebounds by your leading scorer, James Woodard.
Shine blocked, but a foul. Swanigan upset. He can't believe it.
Here you have Tavarius Shine. Hickey pushing it in transition. Shine might have got away with a little bit of walk. That looked like all ball to me by Swanigan with a nice swat protecting the rim.
And the call was for a foul with the body, and you watch that replay, I don't know. It didn't look to be a whole lot of body contact.
Yeah, I just saw some ball contact with the backboard after he got blocked.
I think that's a break for Oklahoma State. Tavarius Shine, freshman from Irving, Texas, Dallas area kid, and they like him a lot.
Yeah, very high on him. They have a nice little nucleus with Oklahoma State that, you know, I believe could be somewhat undervalued in the Big 12, just depending on the Brian Nash. You already see the perimeter defense by Phil Forte and Anthony Hickey, so they cause some problems in the Big 12.
Yeah, I'm with you. I mean, Hickey, Forte, Nash, that's a pretty good core of productive college players. And then if some of these other kids, the freshmen, the younger players, can provide support, I think they got a chance to win a lot of games.
And if you get Cobbins and Anthony Allen working together, providing that rim protection and paint protection, that's always important in the Big 12. They've got really the nucleus to make something happen.
A foul on the floor, Harrison fouled. In that league this year, you better be able to guard the rim, because from Kansas to Texas to Oklahoma to Kansas, I mean, there are big men that you have to contend with every game.
Yeah, not only big men, though, but you have those perimeter players like Buddy Hield with Oklahoma. Like everybody in that league that attacks the rim. Miles Turner with Texas, post player that is starting to shine for them. So really, across the board, you have to be ready to play defense in the Big 12.
Swanigan's provided a nice spark for Tulsa off the bench. Rebound off the free throw miss, and he stuck the ball right back in. Now the Cowboys.
Oklahoma State has done a good job of continuing this lead with LeBryan Nash on the bench.
Forte way outside, hits a three.
Phil Forte almost was in our lap with that shot, Dave. And that's the shot credibility of one of the better three-point shooters in the country.
A 30-footer. This one from closer range for Shaq Harrison.
You going to leave me open? Okay.
Forte swatted to the ground off of Swanigan. He's providing some presence inside. Timeout here in Las Vegas. Forte showing off that range.
Phil Forte, and his forte is threes from deep. Phil Forte, as billed, knockdown three-point shooter. Oklahoma State up. 3:31 left in the first half.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. 36-27, that's the score. Oklahoma State with the lead, 3:31 to go. And the first half, Dave Fleming, Stephen Howard here from Las Vegas. Phil Forte, Stephen, how far was it? Was this a, can I call this a 30-footer?
You can call this a ridiculous footer. I mean, he's so far out, the defensive player turns around like he's not going to take that. And Phil Forte says, look, whenever I am across half court, I'm in range, buddy. A guy that the coach really should be telling the defensive player, the second he comes out of the locker room, I want you inside of his jersey. I want to know what his heart rate is. Phil Forte cannot be open offensively.
Yeah, that was impressive. Forte, who maybe has as much range as anybody in the game, and he showed it off there.
There might be only three players in college basketball that coaches would allow to take that shot.
Well, he's one of them.
Yes.
He made it. Oklahoma State with the lead and the ball. 3:20 to go until half. Freshman Griffin finds Shine, who hits the three. One freshman to another.
Well, Tulsa came out of that timeout in a zone, but I don't know if that's smart against the Oklahoma State team that is feeling very comfortable from the three-point line.
Yeah, making shots in this first half. From the corner, an answer, no. Rebound right, trying to save it in. Forte hustles for the ball.
And again, just like Travis Ford said, whenever there's a loose ball, Phil Forte is so strong. Once he gets his hand on it, nobody is getting it away from him.
That's a good point, because look, he doesn't have the speed, quickness that some other players. He certainly doesn't have the height. It's a very small, by stature, backcourt for the Cowboys, but two kids, Hickey and Forte, have got some muscle, got some size in that regard.
Forte with the grit. Sometimes it's better to have that chip on your shoulder that I think both Hickey and Phil Forte comes with, a guy that's very gritty, just wants to win basketball games, very competitive.
Hickey back in.
Tulsa sticking in that zone despite the fact that Oklahoma State is feeling it from distance.
Here's Hickey going right through that zone, finds Solomon, who's fouled. Another part of that freshman class, maybe the most highly recruited player for the Cowboys from Bixby, Oklahoma, Mitchell Solomon to the line.
And talking to Travis Ford, they have four players that's in their normal rotation with the Brian Nash, Phil Forte, Anthony Higgins, and Cobbin, but the four after that, he says, depending on the day, you can just roll the dice to see who is going to step up. He gives them all a chance, and whoever plays well stays in the game. So he hadn't found that those ancillary players to go with the starters.
Cowboys padding this lead, though, before the free throw, a lane violation. That's an unforced error. That's a mistake. Wiped away a point. Even without it, this is the biggest lead for Travis Ford.
And again, Dave, these last 2 minutes, 30 seconds, very crucial for Tulsa. You don't want to get this far down. You want to get into the single digits, carry some momentum into halftime.
Foul against the Cowboys. That does not make the head coach happy. Double bonus. Tulsa gets a chance for points at the line. You saw that differential in terms of the shooting percentage, 37% for Tulsa. Oklahoma State, against a good defensive team, is shooting 65%.
Very good defensive team. I think you're seeing the offensive woes of Tulsa, who thus far this season have gotten better offensively every game, but not against the Pokes.
First free throw good. Friday at 4 o'clock Eastern, our journey to the tourney game takes us to the Bahamas, and it should be a spirited championship battle for Atlantis. Journey to the tourney presented by Sonic. Friday, 4 Eastern on ESPN, a tournament that has already seen some upsets. Butler took down the fifth-ranked team of the country earlier today, North Carolina.
Yeah, very good Butler basketball team. I think that whole field is dangerous, and you're seeing some great basketball out there.
Oklahoma, a little bit of an upset perhaps over UCLA. Aiden Hammonds driving, had his shot blocked and tipped around. Here comes Tulsa. Ray to Harrison. Harrison foul.
Now on the drive.
Not only does Oklahoma State like to get out in transition, but Tulsa, they get that basketball, push it up quickly, push the envelope. Shaquille Harrison going hard towards the rim, initiating and playing through that contact. Now at the charity stripe, but I like that. Getting your offense from your defense, that's what they did repeatedly in the first game against Auburn. That's what they're going to need to do against Oklahoma State.
Jack Harrison comes up way short on the free throw try. The junior from Kansas City, who started every game last year for Danny Manning, now playing for Frank Haith with the new head coach in place.
And see, with Danny Manning, he didn't really score a lot because they didn't need him to. But with Frank Haith, with his offense, four out, one in, the dribble drive, guards are asked to do more, and they're asked to score. They believe he's going to be very integral for this basketball team.
Cowboys ball, their lead was 13 a moment ago, now it's 10. A whistle away for the ball, offensive foul. Leighton Hammonds, who's had a rough couple minutes, the sophomore.
And you just can't have these off the ball fouls like that, and that's easy. Leaning shoulder into the defensive player, and it's an emphasis this year with officials. You can't impede the progress of the defensive player trying to get to their spot.
He comes out, and the head coach follows him to the bench. Christian Sager, senior, doesn't play big minutes, is in for the Cowboys. Harrison trying to find his teammate. That was not a great pass.
And then, again, you see the activity of Oklahoma State in the lane once you get the ball in there.
Hickey, kind of a circus shot. It goes down.
Hickey, offensively, first half, taking control for Oklahoma State.
Minute 10 to go until halftime. Woodard thought about the long-range three. He's not Phil Forte, though. Woodard, little shot fake. Now a contested two. Rebound. Hickey pulls it away. And Hickey, he just does not want to be conservative. He is in attack mode. Finds Shine, corner three.
If Anthony Hickey is not scoring, Dave, he's facilitating anything positive that's happening for Oklahoma State. Anthony Hickey is somewhere to be found in that play.
Yeah, Hickey is playing really well. The freshman Shine hitting shots, and Oklahoma State up by 15. Anthony Hickey, a three-year starter at LSU, transferred from that program to Oklahoma State, was allowed to play right away with the Cowboys, and right away is an impact player. Oklahoma State with a 15-point lead, final minute of the first half.
You talk to Travis Ford, and he says Anthony Hickey is a guy that can change the game defensively if he wants to. In Vegas, Anthony Hickey has wanted to.
And he's got 9 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. He's doing it on both ends in this first half. Woodard over to Curtis.
Oklahoma State in kind of a matchup zone that has really bothered Tulsa. They haven't been able to figure it out the last 3 trips down the court.
Shine steals the pass. And now Oklahoma State will use a timeout to set up the final attempt of the half. But Travis Ford has to be thrilled with the way his Cowboys are playing. Meanwhile, it's been a little sloppy for Tulsa.
Absolutely. The Oklahoma State has taken control of this basketball game the last 3 minutes. And you can just look. It's been the activity of the hands. Every time Tulsa gets into the paint, you see 3, 4, 5 guys in the paint getting their hands on the ball.
Well, we already mentioned it a moment ago, the headline for the Battle for Atlantis, Butler over the fifth-ranked team of the country in pretty decisive fashion by the end of that game, 74-66. You sort of predicted Georgetown over Florida, so that tournament has been full of upsets, and we are happy to report here in Vegas that one of the all-time greats, Jerry Tarkanian, who was in the hospital, is back at home. We hope he's watching and feeling okay.
Tark the Shark, beloved by everyone in my era, UNLV, Larry Johnson, Greg Anthony, so many dominating teams. Stacey Augmon, who's on the staff there with UNLV right now. It's always good to hear when the Hall of Fame coaches that have had their imprint on the game are doing well.
Yeah, you drive around Vegas, you can't miss Jerry Tarkanian Way. And
no.
For years in these holiday tournaments, Stephen, we come here to Las Vegas for college hoops around Thanksgiving, around Christmas. And Tark is often sitting in the front row. He's still got the towel. So anyway, we hope he is feeling okay. Clock winding down to the first half. Hickey, clock to 3. Hickey to 2. Here's Shine. Did he get it off? He did not, and it didn't go anyway. So not great execution, but overall, a great first half for the Cowboys.
About the only thing that Oklahoma State has done wrong is that last play, but defensively taking control of this game, dictating the pace, and severely taking control of this game in the first half.
Impressive. Oklahoma State 45, Tulsa 30. That's our halftime score. Now we're going to the studio. Jonathan Coachman has the Land Rover halftime report. Welcome back to ESPN College Basketball, the MGM Grand main event from Las Vegas, part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's, and the championship game on this night before Thanksgiving. Halftime score, Oklahoma State with the 45-30 lead over Tulsa. These two teams both won on Monday. Oklahoma State over Oregon State out of the Pac-12. Tulsa took down Auburn, and the winner takes the title in this holiday event. Welcome back here inside the Garden Arena. Dave Fleming alongside Stephen Howard. And Stephen, Tulsa is a very good defensive team. And Oklahoma State's offense just shredded the Golden Hurricane in that first half.
Yeah, Dave, you wouldn't be able to tell by the score how good a team Tulsa is, particularly on the defensive side. But LeBron Nash really had his way in the first half with 12 points, going 5-for-8 from the field wherever they allowed him to shoot, whether it was his mid-range or a nice little pump fake getting into the lane, or with this block shot, defending offensively, nice mid-range, able to dribble into a shot. But again, his partner was Anthony Hickey, who on Monday made his presence felt defensively, but today it's been offense with 9 points, going 4-for-5 from the field, whether it's pushing the envelope in transition or getting into the paint and facilitating. Whenever something positive has happened for Oklahoma State, Anthony Hickey has been somewhere to be found.
Right in the middle of it all, 6 assists for the Cowboys, only 1 assist for Tulsa. The field goal shooting, a huge discrepancy. Tulsa's got a lot to work on here in the second half, and this is a Golden Hurricane team, Stephen. They're taking a jump up in competition this year, going from Conference USA to the American with teams like UConn, like Cincinnati, like Memphis. And this is sort of a taste of what they're going to get on a lot of nights in league play.
And I talked to Frank Haith about that, and he realized that because of that jump in athleticism, in coaching, that this is a growth that they're going to have, and it's good to have it early rather than get shell-shocked right when the American Conference has. But I think you're playing against a very good Oklahoma State team, and this is something that Tulsa's going to face on a nightly basis in the American Athletic Conference.
DeAndre Wright, out of the halftime locker room, had a good look, just missed, and then Cobbins running the floor, could not finish from Hickey, but Forte there for another steal.
Forte just has a knack defensively for the basketball.
Nash shot fake, had it poked away. They're going to call a foul, though, against Tulsa.
Whenever you defend LeBron Nash, there's two things that you have to realize. One, he's got an awesome pump fake. He's going to get you up. And two, he wants to get into the lane. Yes, he can shoot a jump shot, but LeBron Nash wants to get into the lane. You have to realize that. Come under control on your closeout.
So Nash, who, as Stephen documented a moment ago, he had a solid first half. Foul here. Oklahoma State, fresh shot clock with the ball.
Defensively is where Tulsa is going to have to make their mark. That's how they're going to have to get back into this basketball game. They can do it. They did it against Auburn, held them to 35 points in the game. But they're really going to need to turn on those defensive afterburners against Oklahoma State.
Cowboys blew right past that in the first half, and a good start in the second for LeBron Nash.
I really think for LeBron Nash, you're going to have to prevent him from getting the basketball, because DeAndre Wright not doing a good job after the catch at really pushing LeBron Nash out of his sweet spot.
Yeah, that sent right to the bench. Swanigan in now. He played pretty well in limited minutes in the first half for Tulsa. Part of the thing for the Golden Hurricane now, they're going to have to turn it up offensively. Rashad Smith missed the shot out of bounds off of Tulsa. When you're down 17 in the second half, a lot of those shots have to go in.
Well, and that's one of the things you have to realize when you play Tulsa. They're going to attack the rim, but against the Oklahoma State that gets a block on nearly 18% of all defensive possessions, that's top 16 in the country. Tulsa's had a hard time throughout this whole game getting anything clear near the rim.
Here's Nash moving closer in. Nash, not this time.
If they allow Nash to have that type of time with the basketball down on the block, it's going to be a long half, just like the first half for Tulsa.
Yeah, he's going to score more often than not.
And see that hard hedge by LeBron Nash? That's what Tulsa's going to have to do to really affect Phil Forte and Anthony Hickey Jr.
Good defense by Forte. Comes away with the ball after the miss by Shaq Harrison. Forte, three, a little too strong. That one looked pretty good out of his hand.
It really did, but doesn't everything look good out of Phil Forte's hand?
Nash commits the foul. Woodard trying to get to the basket.
And I like that with James Woodard. He senses in his team. This is the guy that's led Tulsa in scoring and rebounds for the first 2 years, freshman and sophomore year. He's the guy that has to push the envelope offensively for them to get back in this game.
Now James Woodard at the free throw line. First of two, no good. And they have not even made free throws. So there's just not a lot going right for Tulsa. They were 8 of 14. They're now 8 of 15 at the line as a team.
You know, Dave, there's times as a team when you go against another one and you're overmatched that things just invariably just don't go right. And you're seeing that against a very capable Oklahoma State team that's really dictating everything in this game.
I didn't know whether Hickey wanted to throw a lob or just shoot the ball. He said, well, I'm just going to shoot it myself.
I don't think Hickey knew, but without any type of contest by Tulsa, he figured I might as well. There's nobody here. Let me just throw it up.
Good point.
I mean, you're looking at a guy, Anthony Hickey, he's only 5'11", really probably 5'9", and not to contest him, it's unacceptable.
Ray dribbles the ball off his leg, out of bounds. It's going from bad to worse for Tulsa.
And just watch Anthony Hickey, the Ocean Parks, and Swanigan just keeps backing up. You have to step up. You got to force Hickey to either pass it or go around you. You can't retreat as a defensive player. That's your paint. You got to protect it.
That will not look good in the film room. That last sequence.
You got Cobbins on Swanigan down low. He's got the size advantage. They need to try to get him a look down low.
Nash. Foul going up for a jump shot. Harrison reaches in, commits personal.
Ryan Nash is a master at drawing contact. He averages 8.7 fouls against him a game. That's top 19th in the country. You add to that shooting around 87% from the free throw line, he makes them pay when they foul him. So Coach Travis Ford said that when he's on the line, he's doing his job, and normally they're going to be up in the game.
And this is the first of two. Look, we've all collectively sort of forgotten about LeBrian Nash from the hype as a freshman, McDonald's All-American. Not just that, even above and beyond that. He's going to be one of the best freshmen to ever play at Oklahoma State. He's going to be this. He's going to be that. And yet he has sort of weathered the ups and downs and looks to me like he's ready for a very big senior year.
One of the problems with LeBrian Nash is he makes things look so easy that you think he's not trying. But one of his problems has been poor body language. And coaches get on him. They need a higher motor, but he's got all the physical attributes and talent.
Played great defense there. Blocked the shot of Rashad Smith. Here's Anthony Hickey. Oklahoma State with a ball of 19. Hickey loses that out of bounds, but off of Tulsa. So the Cowboys keep it with 28 to shoot.
Dave, when you're their aggressor, good things happen to you. Oklahoma State, Anthony Hickey pushing it in transition. Positive things are happening for him. Right now, Tulsa is playing on their heels, and you can see it. Not reacting, not being aggressive offensively. They've got to get something going, or this is going to get ugly very quickly.
Championship game of this MGM Grand main event from Las Vegas. For most of this one, it has been all Cowboys.
Tulsa in the zone now, which again, I don't know if it's very smart.
Forte, though, that time had the shot blocked, the lead pass, and somehow Rashad Ray saves it inbounds.
Which is the reason why I am an analyst and not a coach.
Harrison up top. I think you could do it. Smith in the lane. No good.
I think what impresses me with Oklahoma State is the number of offensive weapons that they have, but more importantly, the identity of this team is on the defensive end of the court, and whenever you have that with the ability to score, that's when you have teams that can do damage.
Woodard to that free throw area, too strong. Forte with that strength rips the ball away. Now in transition, Forte lays it in.
And you saw him attack the defensive player going into the body, using the rim to protect his shot. Very high basketball IQ play.
Swanigan, not an outside shooter. He gives it up to Harrison. Foul as Harrison goes to the basket that sends us to a timeout.
Phil Forte in transition, so strong, able to knock down three-point shots, but this time taking it coast to coast with the strength, using the rim to protect the basketball. The bench loves it. Phil Forte loves it. Oklahoma State up 19. 15 minutes left to go in the second half.
Late night college hoops in Las Vegas and all Oklahoma State in this one. Second half action championship game of the MGM Grand main event. Dave Fleming, Stephen Howard with you. The night before Thanksgiving, Oklahoma State getting ready to compete in the rugged Big 12. Look at the depth in the league. Picked to be eighth in that conference preseason. Not playing like the eighth team in that league here tonight.
Right, and I think they're better than that, but who they're going to knock off? Yep. I mean, you look at Kansas State with Marcus Foster. Oklahoma, you got Ryan Spangler and Tyshawn Taylor, the transfer from Houston. Iowa State, Fred Hoiberg with George Niang. Baylor, they always had that impressive front line. West Virginia, they just knocked off UConn in the Puerto Rico Challenge. So Big 12 is coming to play this year, but I think Oklahoma State could be in the mix, but that's going to be a hard-fought conference this year.
Yeah, and remember, everybody plays the pure double round robins. Everybody plays everyone else home and away, which changes the dynamic of things so significantly. And heck, even teams, I mean, TCU, Trent Johnson's team is finally healthy. They've got some talented players down low. They're not going to go winless in conference play again.
Yeah, look at the bottom of your conference. You have Tubby Smith, Hall of Fame coach at Texas Tech. Trent Johnson, who's been coach of the year everywhere that he's been at. Stanford, LSU, he's at TCU. They're going to be good. There is no easy wins in the Big 12.
52-33, Oklahoma State. Travis Ford's team playing well. Anthony Hickey from LSU, now with the Cowboys, had the ball knocked out of bounds off of Tulsa. And this is the guy. Look, Marcus Smart isn't here. Markell Brown's not here. This is the guy who can fill some of that void. He is a very talented kid.
You're absolutely right, Dave. the point guard position is the most important high school, college, in the NBA. First line of defense or defense, and the initiator of your offense. So it starts and stops with the point guard.
Forte, shot clock winding out, had to get one up, had it rejected. Here comes Harrison.
And that's really what you want Phil Forte to do. You want him to put him on the bounce and attack the rim. You'd much rather him do that than shoot three-pointers.
We saw him hit a 30-plus footer from three in the first half. He's practically sitting in our chair. Zach Harrison down the lane. Tough move. He scores.
Rashard Smith, or Harrison, rather. Great move. You just saw him not giving up, being relentless, going at the rim. And Tulsa, they're really going to have to do that offensively and defensively to get back into this game.
Yeah, there's still plenty of time to go, so the game's not over as poorly as the Golden Hurricane have played. Now a whistle and no shot, a foul against the Cowboys away from the ball.
You'll take a look at this shot by Shaquille Harrison, and you see him ducking his head, little push up there, but going through two Oklahoma State defenders, even the rim protector of Anthony Allen, weaving in through there. Very athletic play by Tulsa.
Well, Allen's got three fouls. He'll sit back down on the bench. Curtis bounced it to nobody but Phil Forte.
And they were open, but it was the wrong color jersey.
Yeah, and not easy to mistake Oklahoma State wearing those bright oranges. Forte. Carroll finds Hickey in the corner. Three goes down.
Yeah, that's when, as a defense, as an opposing coach, you just say, Because you game plan to let Anthony Hickey shoot that shot. Prevent Phil Forte, but you want other guys to beat you. Those other guys for Oklahoma State are beating you.
Curtis trying to find the cutter. Bad pass. Another steal for the Cowboys. And Hickey turns on the Jets. That bounce pass was partially deflected. Carroll caught it anyway, then missed the shot.
Carroll needs to make the extra pass. That was a situation where that youth really got ahead of him. You had Phil Forte at the top of the key.
Woodard can't answer on this end. Foul against Tulsa.
Taking a look at that last shot by Anthony Hickey. And just good job by Carroll. Brings in the defense to him. Anthony Hickey very confident on the baseline. Give me the ball anywhere, I'm making it happen.
You know, one thing that the coaches love about Hickey, he's a kid from Hopkinsville, Kentucky, was not recruited by the Wildcats, so he went to LSU in the SEC. Every time LSU played Kentucky, he had a big game. He had great career numbers against his home state Wildcats. He's got that sort of chip on his shoulder mentality. They love that about him.
Anytime you have a player that's below 6 foot, if they're good, they're playing with a chip on their shoulder. And you see Phil Forte and Anthony Hickey Jr. doing that exceptionally well.
Hickey to Solomon, nice. Cutting to the basket. Foul. Well, the freshman didn't finish, but a great look again from Hickey. So he didn't get stat credit for the assist, but he made that happen. He's making everything happen for the Cowboys. Up 20 with 11:55 to go. From Las Vegas, 55-35, all Oklahoma State in this in-state rivalry over Tulsa. Second half from the MGM Grand. It's the main event here the night before Thanksgiving championship game as these two teams battling for the title. One thing I love about this event, not just that it's here in Vegas, great arena with a lot of history, but I love the prize for the winner. It's not a trophy. We're in the city, we're in the arena of so many great fights. So why not give a championship belt to the winner?
The champ is here. I just want to know who is big enough on any of these teams to be able to fit in that belt.
Yeah, Phil Forte is going to topple over if he tries to put that thing
literally
on.
Literally.
Maybe Mitchell Solomon could handle that thing. The big freshman makes the first of two free throws. Kid they think has a chance to be a good player. He'll be a role player this year for Travis Ford. Oklahoma State came here to Vegas with wins, but having not been challenged by real good competition, they've played better competition here in this tournament. Maybe not elite, but better, and have looked really good.
Exceptionally good. And I think that these are those early tournaments that once you get in the conference season, not only are you going to pay dividends once NCAA tournament time comes, but down the stretch when you're playing against teams, you can, your memory is going to remember how you fared in these tournaments, and you're going to be able to build on that confidence that you gained here.
Nash back in. Hammonds takes a seat on the bench. Number five, Tavarius Shine, freshman who is guarding the ball right here. Harrison, I think he's got a chance to be a good one. Played good defense there, but committed the foul.
Good job by Harrison. Recognized the fact that he had the quickness on Shine and just took him to the rim.
Shaquille Harrison, his teammates, and not a surprise, call him Shaq, misses the first of two free throws.
You know, talking to Frank Haith before the game, the offensive woes for him really is to be expected. A whole new system, the four out one in, dribble drive, but the one thing that they have going for them is they have veteran leadership, very junior strong roster, and you have four returning starters that were juniors, so I think the learning curve for them is going to be a little bit heightened than it would be for another team that didn't have that many veterans.
Anthony Hickey was just the one-man press break, dribbled right through the defense. That's a nice security blanket for a coach to have. You don't have to spend a whole lot of time on press break offense when you have Hickey.
Just get it to Hickey.
Nash, spin move, foul. Well, you mentioned that veteran presence, and maybe the new offensive system will take some time for Tulsa, but another thing that Frank told us, this should be a good defensive team, and I guarantee you that's bugging him about this game tonight. Oklahoma State still shooting 57% for the game.
Well, they normally are a very good defensive team, and you know, offensively, their effective field goal percentage before this game was 39.3%. That's top 25 in the country. But again, you're going against a high Division I, high power conference team, and they're really just having their will offensively and defensively with Oklahoma State.
Nash hands back to Forte. That was a long two, and he banked it in. Teammates help him get up. He slid his way right into the bench. Forte with the bucket. Right. Scores with a foul. Nice move from big man.
Taking a look at that last play. Watch Phil Forte. Feet on the line. Kissed it off the glass. But he's a guy that 87.5% of his shots come without the dribble, but he's showing the ability to go off the dribble, kiss it, make it, get some dap by his teammates. Phil Forte doing his thing from distance.
He's got 12. Free throw good. DeAndre Wright completes the three-point play. More pressure from Tulsa. This time it's Forte who will handle it. What do we say about that press break? Get the ball to number 12.
And the thing that's difficult to press Oklahoma State is you have four capable ball handlers on the court that are very quick. And so I think that's one of the problems that Tulsa's having.
Forte to Solomon, was left open, passed up the jumper. Maybe that's not a bad decision. Hickey fouled by Rashad Ray.
As a coach, you hate to see that. 6 seconds left to go. You negate all your defense by fouling 50 feet away from the rim.
That will cause a coach to scratch his head at a minimum.
Yes.
Rub those temples a little bit. Fresh shot clock for the Cowboys. Under 10 to go, and Oklahoma State firmly in control. This one up by 20. We expected a close, competitive game after the way Tulsa played on Monday. Cowboys just been too good.
Well, I think the issue is both very capable defenses, but Tulsa have struggled thus far offensively, where Oklahoma State, very good team offensively throughout this early part of the season.
Yeah, there's no LeBron Nash on Tulsa. Nash has been a shot maker. He's got 17.
And you're seeing the mismatch offensively with LeBron Nash at 6'7", able to post you, shoot from three, hit the mid-range, can facilitate, block shots. So he can do a lot of things.
Curtis dribbled right into his teammate, almost lost the ball. Here's Ray, foul.
Now, hold up the lane. Number 12, Anthony Hickey. Anthony Hickey, second personal.
It's kind of been one of those days, Dave, for Tulsa where things just aren't going right. The ball has bounced for Oklahoma State, but some of that has been Oklahoma State creating that type of scenario.
Yep. They do deserve a lot of credit for it. Free throw line, two shots for Rashad Ray. Well, it's going to be a year of transition for Tulsa with the new head coach and the new conference, and the American is a big step up from Conference USA. Even with Louisville moving on out of the American to the ACC, Frank Haith knows it's going to be a big challenge.
But I think this is a huge potential for the American Athletic Conference. With UConn, the defending champions, SMU in second, Memphis third, Cincinnati fourth, and then right now Tulsa picked fifth in the American. You've got potentially 5-6 conference or NCAA tournament teams in the field. They're going to bring up that RPI of the American Athletic Conference.
Forte cuts to the basket, and his teammate Cobbins found him for the lay-in. Great passing by the big man. Woodard, three, off iron. His shooting has been cold again tonight.
Yeah, you look at a player that can score like James Woodard, and you think, wow, when's he going to get it going? But you got to tip your hat to the defense. Oklahoma State, whether it's been Hickey, Phil Forte, they've been hawking him relentlessly, bringing in fresh defenders. That's difficult for an offensive player to deal with.
James Woodard, 2-for-10, shooting the ball. Forte, he wanted to shoot one there.
And not only that, you have to guard Forte and Hickey defensively, so that's tiring for a player like Woodard.
Nash came up short. Tulsa wanted to push off. Here's Rashad Ray. Ray dishes to Smith, who throws an elbow.
Yeah, that could have been easily offensive.
Yeah, Shine is complaining about it. He's called for the personal foul. Travis Ford can't believe it. But Phil Forte from the outside, and even a little closer to the basket, he's been effective tonight.
Michael Cobbins, great give and go. Forte fakes up to the basket. Nice ball reversal. Back door, Phil Forte laying it in. Oklahoma up a lot. 8 minutes left to go in the game.
63-41, that's the lead for Oklahoma State in the second half. 7:58 to go in the championship of this MGM Grand main event. Frank Haith and the Golden Hurricane taking that step up into the American, where that conference had big-time success last year, not just the national champions UConn in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, SMU got to the championship game in the NIT, ended up losing to Minnesota. I think SMU has kind of hit a little bit of a speed bump, though, losing three big games that they needed, I think, to get into the NCAA, Gonzaga, Indiana, and Arkansas at home. But American, very capable conference, and I think the addition of Tulsa really is going to bode well for that conference. Great addition.
So it will not be easy for Frank Haith and company.
And really what you're doing is you're kind of going from a mid-major to a power conference, similar to what Memphis did, but Memphis a little bit more, I guess, stacked when they made that jump.
He's been to the tournament with Miami, a program that had not had a lot of recent success when he took over. Missouri, which had success, but they've had some big-time seasons at Mizzou.
He's averaged 20.5 wins per season and has 8 postseason appearances. So when Tulsa was able to get Frank Haith, that was a big coup in my mind for the University of Tulsa.
Darius Shine, the freshman for the Cowboys, has played well, goes to the basket, lays it in.
And I don't know how that contact was not a foul. Either a block or a charge when you have stuff down around the rim when you have an offensive player with the basketball.
Well, maybe the official starting to think about Thanksgiving dinner tomorrow.
Yeah. Somebody might have a late red-eye flight home.
Potatoes.
Keep going.
Cowboys foul on number 12, Anthony Hickey.
Foul that time, they did blow the whistle. Anthony Hickey wasn't happy.
18 foul.
Hey, no rest for the weary. Holiday time in this sport. You work college hoops, you're going to be working around Thanksgiving, around Christmas. And the players love these kind of events. They get to come to a place like Las Vegas, cram in a bunch of games in a short period of time. You have school vacations, so at least for a few days you're not working on the schoolwork and the basketball work at the same time.
you look at Tulsa, they take a charter after the game tonight, and then they have Wichita State on Friday, and Creighton right after that. So you alluded to that. This is when a lot of basketball is played for most teams, and this is the time where you get better.
Yeah, they're going to get tested. You mentioned those upcoming games. That will not be easy for them. They're going to have to play a lot of better than they did tonight. Ball movement on the outside, LeBryan Nash, with both Forte and Hickey now on the bench. Under 7 to go.
Oklahoma State very content to get the shot that they want in no hurry at all.
Nash pulls up, 3, too strong. And the good news is they took a lot of clock on that possession with the big lead. Woodard rejected by Cobbins, who not only blocks it, but saves it inbounds.
That's one of the things Oklahoma State has. They have rim protection. They block 18% of the shots that get to the rim. Top 16 in the country, Cobbins, the leader of that charge.
A lot of height on the roster just on paper, but a lot of shot blocking ability. Cobbins is a very good one. Good look from Cobbins to Shine, the freshman, too strong.
Yeah, not a lot of height, but a lot of athleticism with that front line, and particularly when you add to that the pressure defense, but Allen Jr. off the bench, another very capable shot block.
And he does have the pure height on paper. He's the one guy.
He's a footer.
Yeah, he is. Reaches that 7-foot mark. Again, Oklahoma State's going to work clock here. Up big in the second half. Looking for what would be a very satisfying win against a longtime in-state rival.
Just has bragging right implications at home. But I think more importantly, a big win that I think is going to resonate for Oklahoma State for weeks to come.
Wow, Nash with the left hand high off the glass. Spectacular shot by LeBryan Nash.
Really showing all of his arsenal offensively today. LeBryan Nash doing a good job for the Oklahoma State folks.
Contested 3, Nash then fouled, going for the rebound.
Take a look at this last basket by LeBryan Nash. Takes it left, nice crossover move, hesitation into the lane, finger roll off the glass. That's a high skill set move by LeBryan Nash, going offhand to lay it in.
All conference teams are going to be packed in the Big 12 this year. You got big men, you got guards, you got a lot of individual talent, even with the kids who left for the draft, like the Kansas players, Embiid and Wiggins. But Nash, he's going to contend for all Big 12.
Oh, without a doubt. I think he's an early front runner. And you have a lot of players, though, that are going to be on those second and third teams. Isaiah Taylor for Texas, standout guard, broke his wrist. But still, they have very capable backups with Texas, with Javon Felix. But down the all 10 of the Big 12, they have exceptional players.
Jonathan Holmes playing really well for the Longhorns. A senior, kind of an under-the-radar type player.
A guy that started all 4 years, so he's weathered the storm.
Gone from bad of that program to very good. Texas is playing really well.
Fourth personal.
Talented freshman Miles Turner had a big game the other night for Rick Barnes.
In West Virginia, beating UConn. Upset victory, Puerto Rico tip-off.
Yeah, their point guard, Juwan Staten, who's clearly one of the best players in that league, maybe a chance for player of the year in the conference. But Devin Williams, their big man, has had a monster start for the year for Bob Huggins.
Well, Staten was the preseason pick of the player of the year, but yeah, Coach Huggins, you can tell, not satisfied with his West Virginia Mountaineers not playing that Huggins type of basketball, which is defense, which is hard-nosed, which is gritty, the blue-collar style of that area.
Nash comes out of the game, and maybe for the last time, with the 25-point lead, 4:52 to go. If so, a nice night's work for LeBryan Nash.
Unlace the shoes, give me the ice pack. My job is done.
It's a lane violation on that last missed free throw. Nash, 21 points, very efficient, 8 of 14, 4 rebounds, played some good defense too.
You know, this is going to be the second straight year that Oklahoma State has started 6-0. They haven't done that since the 1936-1937 season.
And again, a year of less expectation for the Cowboys, certainly than last year, but a team that looks ready to maybe exceed those expectations. Newberry, two. Rebound, Tulsa.
These last 4 minutes are going to be important for Coach Travis Ford. Again, trying to find those other players on the bench that are going to help that front four.
Yeah, these are minutes that aren't going to decide this game, but they help decide the rotation once you get to conference play.
Yeah, because outside of that four of Nash, Forte, Hickey, and Cobbins, there's been a lot of inconsistency, and he needs to find players. Not that let me see on a given night, but I know on a given night what I'm going to get from you.
We saw Travis Ford, who was a great college player himself and has been at the helm of this Cowboys program for a good long while now.
That was the number one.
And it is funny how Coach Ford, who's an undersized college player but turned himself into an excellent player for Kentucky, seems to recruit players sort of in his own mold.
You're right. You got Keaton Page on the bench, who's an exceptional player for Oklahoma State, much like Phil Forte. Now you got Anthony Hickey Jr. that they brought over from LSU, and you know he's a guy, as you mentioned, able to get those guys, whether small or tall, and make a competitive team with them.
Yeah, Hickey, Forte, Tyree Griffin, Page, you mentioned. Second free throw, good. Coach Ford, who played for Kentucky, and I mean he was a very good college player back in the early 1990s. Kentucky All-Stars, number two.
You know he was getting carded until he was 30 years old.
Maybe still.
Yeah.
Tyree Griffin had it stripped away. Woodard stepped back, leaned in, and banked it in. That is a three. Kept the feet behind the line.
Woodard.
Also wants pressure here. Hammonds to Griffin. Timeout for Coach Ford, who wasn't real thrilled with that last sequence. He's still got a 20-point lead, so he can be cranky and be happy at the same time. 3:47 away from a championship in Las Vegas, Oklahoma State with the lead. Great sight for college hoops. We're in Las Vegas the night before Thanksgiving inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena, a host to many big-time sporting events, entertainment acts, and for the first time ever, the MGM Grand main event, part of Feast Week, presented by Lowe's. 20-point lead for Oklahoma State.
Very decisive win by Oklahoma State. One from end to end, I think they controlled, they dictated the tempo defensively and offensively. They really got the shots they wanted for the most part in the game.
I think they like that shot. Phil Forte just sort of
short-armed it.
Yeah. Nash tried to take a charge. He does. Offensive foul. Well, Brian Nash, they got the starters back in. Coach Ford wasn't real happy with a two-minute sequence, so the starters back in. We'll see how long they play when we come back. 20-point lead for the Cowboys. Point lead for Oklahoma State, 3:16 away in front of some of their spirited fans in Las Vegas of a championship here in the MGM Grand main event. Meanwhile, on Saturday, the main event in the state of Alabama, it's the Iron Bowl, Auburn, Alabama in Tuscaloosa, and we have it for you, 7:45 Eastern on Saturday on ESPN. Stephen Howard, you got a pick in the Iron Bowl this year?
All I know is that Chris Davis will live in infamy for those guys. 109-yard field goal return for Auburn. But I like Alabama. Nick Saban's got them ready, and after what happened last year, there's no way that they're not going to come ready to just unload once that starting buzzer sounds.
Auburn has won 5 of the last 7 in Tuscaloosa. That's hard to believe.
It is. It is.
Last year, of course, on the plains with the incredible last-second win.
And Travis Ford sending a clear signal to the bench that playing time is earned. And it doesn't matter if we're up 30, 20, 10. If you get on the court, you need to play at that same level as the starters, or you're going to go back to the bench. And I think that's important for your team to realize.
And I bet you he'll be delivering that message in the locker room postgame.
I guarantee you he'll be delivering that message.
Forte, long range three. Tulsa ball. 2.5 to go from Vegas. Harrison traveled. I think it's a good point you make, though, because he got some freshmen in off the bench, and we assume that they'd be in there for the rest of the game. A couple of turnovers, some sloppy plays, right back alongside the head coach.
Well, if you're looking at being successful, particularly in your conference and then in the postseason, when you let those bench players come in, they need to have their own identity, and they need to not let the level of play go down. And you saw that clearly with the bench of Oklahoma State. They didn't come in with any type of intensity.
And the freshman Burt was wide open, so he shot the three, missed it. It's fun watching Anthony Hickey just even bring the ball up the court. He is that dynamic. There's a three. Too little too late for Markel Curtis. But Frank Haith, I think at this point, is looking for something positive. Steven, you mentioned the upcoming schedule with Wichita State and a Creighton team that's been impressive without Doug McDermott. So the non-conference is going to test the Golden Hurricane.
Yeah, you're coaching past this game. You know this game has been lost. And right now you're just trying to implement those moments for later down the road so that this team can improve. And Frank Haith, new coach with Tulsa, he's trying to implement a new system, trying to brand this team, and this is going to go really far in doing that. But I think the competitiveness that they've shown thus far has been there, but they've just been overmatched by a very capable Oklahoma State team.
It's sort of a theme, Stephen, of this early season for a lot of these programs that we've seen, certainly for several in this event with Wayne Tinkle now at the head of Oregon State, with Bruce Pearl, our former colleague at ESPN, now the head coach at Auburn, and these games can look so much different than the same teams playing even just a few weeks from now.
And one thing, though, for Frank Haith, of those three coaching changes, he has the easiest job of all of them. What Wayne Tinkle has to do in Oregon State is change the culture. Bruce Pearl at Auburn changed the culture of a team that's been really at the dregs of a power conference for a very long time.
Well, and you're right about that, in that Tulsa, they were an NCAA tournament team last year. And even though Danny Manning, their head coach, left, a lot of their top players are back here this year.
I mean, they won Conference USA, and you have your leading scorer there. You have the nucleus of your team. But they are moving up in a conference that now they're going from the mid-major to a power conference.
Well, Oklahoma State is going to get this win, but Shaq Harrison with the nice finish, drawing a foul. And these last few minutes have been, I think, discouraging would be a fair word.
Shaq Harrison taking it into the paint, switching hands midair to use the left off the glass. A lot of dexterity in the paint.
Harrison trying to complete the three-point play. This one almost stolen away. More sloppy moments for the Cowboys. It won't matter in terms of the result, but an 11-0 run for Tulsa. I think one thing we've established with the Cowboys, they're not a particularly deep team.
No, they're not. And that's another thing that hurt them against Oklahoma State, because Oklahoma State just kept bringing defenders, fresh defenders, to go against Woodard, to go against DeAndre Wright. And that's very hard for a team to withstand.
1 minute.
And Tavarius Shine stood out to me. Sager wide open, misses the three. Ball to the Cowboys still. Freshman who played well, Tavarius Shine. I think he's got a chance to be a rotation player and a productive one for the Cowboys. Otherwise, it's a top-heavy team leaning on their stars.
But with Oklahoma State, though, you know everything starts and stops with LeBron Nash. He's going to have an exceptional year for Oklahoma State to break into that top five in the Big 12.
With a foul. Nice finish for the Cowboys. 29.3 seconds to go.
Nice take into the paint. No rim protection. Playing through contact. And these players showing that, hey, even though we're coming off the bench, this means something for us as well.
Coming up next, NBA tonight, when we are finished here from Las Vegas. Three-point play. And the shot clock is off now. Tulsa with the basketball. And I'm going to regroup after this one. Another whistle and a foul.
Number 4, Joe Burton, his first personal.
Shaq Harrison has been a bright spot tonight for Tulsa. He will get to the line a lot. A very aggressive player. And I think in a way, Steven, Tulsa is going to need to do that. Now, Harrison surprises everybody, intentionally misses the free throw. Actually executed it pretty well.
Oh, wait, look at Coach Frank head down. Saying, I don't really know what you're trying to get with this play, but that's not what we needed right now.
Well, I mean, he surprised even his head coach. He certainly surprised me. Well, okay, high fives, get organized, get the basketball.
Whoop. Trying to quick shot, and that's the right thing to do. I mean, Oklahoma State was not ready for that play. I don't think anybody was ready for that play. But I don't think at this juncture, when you're down that much, what you attempt to prove.
Well, save that one for when it really matters. That's actually a nice technique. You see teams try that when they desperately need it. Say they're down two with one free throw coming and 1 second left to play. I would try doing it the way Shaq Harrison just did it.
Yeah, and the mistake most people make is that they just hit the backboard without the rim. But, yeah, you hit that front rim and it's going to come right back to you. So smart play, but not necessarily a good play at this juncture of this game.
Offensive rebound, put back good for Tulsa. Final 10 seconds will wind down here. Oklahoma State will grab that championship belt. They beat their in-state rivals, the Tulsa Golden Hurricane, and they are the champs of the MGM Grand main event here in 2014. And Stephen, for Travis Ford and company, predicted to be eighth in the Big 12. It's a very tough conference, but a really encouraging start for the Cowboys.
Very encouraging, and you love the perimeter front line of Hickey and Phil Forte, but the main cog is LeBron Nash, and I think he solidified the fact that he's going to vie for some sort of Big 12 Player of the Year, playing exceptional, doing the things that they need him to do.
So the Cowboys come away with the victory. They beat Oregon State on Monday. They beat Tulsa here tonight, 73-58. The final score. For Stephen Howard and our entire ESPN crew, Dave Fleming saying so long. Thanks for being with us here from Vegas. It was a fun week at the MGM Grand, and the main event championship goes to the Cowboys of Oklahoma State as they take down Tulsa by that final score.